Nighttime on Still Waters. This is NB506812, narrowcasting into the night from somewhere on Britain's waterways. October 16th, Friday. The canal continues to thread its silent way through autumn. There's a hint now of the rise of mist on colder dawns. But today, it lies still and steely. Penny trots ahead, tail up, relaxed, contentedly sniffing the trail and foil of the unseen world. The hedges are garlanded with crimson rosehip lanterns and bryony's poisonous fire. The air is filled with the smell of damp earth, leaf mould, wood smoke. And together we walk through the mystery of autumn. This is Narrowboat the Erica, coming to you through the dark, canal side. Tonight's almost as dark as you can get it. A few hours back, the new moon was 0.0%. Heavy cloud, the sort that's misted with rain, snuffs out astral light. Outside my cabin window, reflected light seeps oily across the treacle black water. And Erica lies cocooned in a friendly dark. Thank you for all the comments and feedback that you've given me from episode one and all the questions. And I plan over the next couple of episodes to answer them and to talk more about NB506812, the Erica. And tonight, I want to start by talking about the history of her and what we know. She's 18 years old and before us had one owner who seemed to have lavished a lot of love and care on her. And from what we can gather from that, the stash of waterways guides, rain-stained, dog-eared and laughter-lined, she seemed to have had a full life, cruising the home counties, including London and the Midlands. But she seemed to spend a lot of time on the Fenland waterways, or those big watery skies. Their pages are full of pen-marked cryptic messages.
1530, Tuesday, 27th. Thursday, 1700 hours. Good morning. Maud sat, Fotheringhay Bridge. Mango, Thai and Indian rest, brackets good. Good morning site, / TV reception, look east.
Ciphers of old summers, meadows sweet with cow, lark song under cumulus castle skies. Modern narrowboat designs are broadly based on the traditional working boats and are flat-bottomed, busy-nosed, faithful. They're the old Labradors of the boating world. And quite often I'm asked, when you're on board, do you feel it rock? And to be honest, I don't really notice it. And unless you're sitting at certain points or looking down the boat, you don't really seem to notice it when you're sitting along the sides on the sofa. But where I do notice it is when I'm on land. The ground doesn't move. It's too solid, too unyielding. And sometimes when I sit at the desk in my office, it doesn't move and I kind of get that disorienting feel. The Erica is deep forest green. The green of vicarage lawns and Victorian bottle glass. I love the old traditional narrowboat paintwork. Colourful, bright, vivid, full of energy and life. But I don't know why, but I'm glad that Erica is not painted in those colours. She would be different. Not Erica. Not us. When we bought her, her name was Mystique, and she'd been named after the owner's dog, also a collie, called Mist, or Misty. And we were going to keep it, because we quite liked the idea of holding on to that name and those memories. But as the work progressed and she was refitted out, she changed and no longer seemed to be the Mystique of those old Fenland summers. And so we decided to rename her as she became more and more part of our lives. And we both went away and wrote down lists of names we thought might be suitable. And when we came back, we both had the Erica fairly high on our lists. And that really decided it. It felt right. Erica was my mum. And her fondest memories were of her time living on the canal. She, my dad and sister Wendy lived in a converted ship's lifeboat, the Cathy, on the Grand Union Canal at Hampton Hall Farm in Rickmansworth. And it was on this boat that I was born. And all through Mum's life, her memories seemed to return to those times, that little nest of memories that were built on this little wooden boat. And she seemed to miss the elements. The sound of rain on water, the pull of water among reeds, the smell that you get when you raise the lock gate sluice, the space. And she wrote about these times in her memoirs. And I think I'll read them perhaps in future episodes. At her funeral, I read out some extracts, and now I'm here, on board. It's somehow home. And I understand. The jigsaw that defies completion yields another couple of pieces. I'll be posting some photographs of the Cathy in those times on social media, so please have a look. The details, the Instagram, Twitter, and the Facebook accounts are in the details, the program details below. And so it all really just leaves me to wish you a very peaceful night. Good night. Tonight's weather on the Erica. Temperature, outside 8.2 degrees, inside 24 degrees. Humidity, 95%. Dew point, 8.3. Wind direction, northeast. Strength, 5 to 9 miles per hour. Barometric pressure, 1021.3, falling. Precipitation, 2.3 millimeters. Moon phase, new, 0.1%. Sunset, 18:07. Sky casting, 7:35.